Hello and welcome to LiveBoard tutorial. Are you ready to learn everything you need to know about using LiveBoard? Let's dive in. To start using LiveBoard, go to LiveBoard's website or open the app and click on the sign up button. Create a profile using your Google account or by providing basic information like your name, email address, and password. You'll be happy to know that you can activate your free trial account and gain full access to all of premium features for 14 days. Once you have an account, you can start creating groups to organize your online classrooms for a specific group of students or to group your boards within folders. Simply click on the Create Group button, name it, and add students to the group to get access to all the sessions and recordings within the classroom. To create a session, click on Create Board button. You can create the boards from a ready PDF or start with a blank page. LiveBoard operates on all devices and platforms, including web, iOS, and Android. When it's time to invite students to your live session, you can do it in three ways: via a public link, by sharing a session code, or via their email address. Your students don't even need to register on the platform, so it's a seamless process. LiveBoard has an inbuilt video conferencing tool that lets you start a call with unlimited students with no time limitation directly from your board. You can also share your screen during the call. Now, let's explore the tools in the control panel. To save your session as a recording, click Record, and it will capture your drawings and explanations, saving them to both your cloud and local storage. This way, absent students can catch up and you can share your teachings on your YouTube channel. You can enable or disable students' drawing permissions. This prevents learners from being distracted and helps all students stay focused on the task. You can now collaborate in real time. Everything you draw on the board will be visible to the students on their boards and vice versa. The follower mode. When it is activated, your students follow wherever you go on the board and cannot see anything apart from the page that you are currently showing them. And if disabled, students can move through the pages themselves. Track students' attention at any given moment to know if they are actually following the lesson, or left the space, or maybe scrolling through their social media. The chat functionality allows anyone on the board to ask questions in real time. Assessments. With LiveBoard, you can create on-the-spot interactive quizzes and assess students' performance in real time. Before your session, go to your assessments library, create and name a new assessment, and start building your test. You can add unlimited single and multiple choice questions and even include images. After building your assessment, save it. If needed, you can always edit the question list by adding or deleting questions. Now, during the live sessions with your students, click the quiz button and select an assessment from your library. Now, click Start. Your students will be able to see the test right away and fill it in. Once they submit their answers, LiveBoard automatically tracks their progress. When the time is up, simply click the Finish button to end the assessment and get the report. Let's now explore the whiteboarding tools. LiveBoard has a robust whiteboard with a variety of tools to create engaging sessions. You can use shapes, pens, and text to add visual interest to your board. You can always see and navigate through your pages by clicking on this button. The platform even has advanced time-specific tools. Insert math equation with LateX editor for more complex equations with just one click. And the Desmos Graph editor lets you create and manipulate mathematical graphs within the platform. This allows students to visualize and explore math concepts in a dynamic and interactive way. To access your board pages, open the page bar. From there, you can duplicate, delete, and move your pages. Change the background color and grid type of your board from the page settings from the menu on the right. You can add images, maps, and other visual aids and enrich your session with visual resources. You can even use a pointer to highlight a specific part of your board. To insert an image, pick it either from your collection or the web by drag and dropping it onto your board. Create worksheets by importing PDF documents and save tons of time. Simply select the file, choose the preferred pages, and click on Insert button. To stop recording your board session, click on the Stop button. You will then be able to save your recording to your local storage or LiveBoard cloud. To save your remote session content, easily export it as a PDF file and share it with your students or parents. You can also upload this content to professional platforms or save them for later reuse. Now let's go back to your dashboard, where you have your account information, classrooms, boards, and recordings. Access your board settings from the dashboard to move your boards to a group or to rename, duplicate, and delete them. Your account settings are near your avatar in the top right corner. If needed, you can access tutorials and a guided tour from here, edit your personal information, and view your current plan and billing details. On the dashboard, you can also find links to LiveBoard social media pages as well as access LiveBoard support, which is always available to help you if you have any questions. Thank you for watching. Leave your questions below and subscribe to our channel.